I would venture to guess there's people in the room that are familiar with the stories in the book of Genesis, where there was a time when the Israelites were wandering in the desert and all of a sudden bread came down from heaven. That's kind of what today feels like for us to have KCP join.
Kentavious Caldwell-Pope got drafted by the Detroit Pistons, and I'm from Detroit, so I got a little connection with Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. Mind you, I did not like him as much as other Pistons fans because I'm a Laker fan. But when he got traded to my Lakers, I thought to myself, man, this guy might break out. And what we got was a shot-chucking, always falling ass, think he a 30-point per game scorer player. That's what we got. And you know, Laker fans, we go crazy with the slander. If you play bad even once, you're getting bullied. In real life, on social media, we will break you spiritually, emotionally, mentally, financially. The Laker fan base can break you in many ways. Now, I'm trying to get myself right. You know what I'm saying? Bullying is not okay. But in this case, bullying is great. My apologies to Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. I apologize.
Say I'm sorry for the things I've done, and I try and be stronger in this life I chose, but I want you to know
I hated on you when you was airballing threes, when you was missing dunks. But one thing about you, KCP, you have never wavered. You have never given up. This man does not get injured. You can shoot KCP in his back 4 times. He will play on Thursday. He will play that next game. He will play that back-to-back. Kentavious Caldwell-Pope in the regular season only averaged 9 points. Now, I know it's not a big jump, but KCP has improved in the playoffs. And he had his best game ever as a Laker. Ever. 15 points and 2 clutch baskets with that 3. We got a mic bring bang from KCP. What in the hell? He took Duncan Robinson's slow ass off the dribble. Laid the ball up. He's not scared. You can do anything to KCP. He is not scared of the moment. It's a good thing and a bad thing. He might shoot an air ball one game, but then he might knock down the 30-footer with a hand in his face. He reminds me of J.R. Smith, you know what I'm saying, before he got bad, but this KCP is playing defense. This KCP is rotating. This KCP is guarding the best players. Like, we always talk about KCP can cook on defense, but he has to guard these great players. He was guarding Jamal Murray. He was guarding Kawhi Leonard. You know what I'm saying? He had to guard these great players, but he's always hustling back. You never see KCP not hustle. That's what I like. He knows his role, and he's playing it. Without KCP that game, I don't know if he was going to win, bro. I don't know if he was going to win. The fact that your two best players trust you, and Anthony Davis and LeBron James, speaks volume.
You know, KCP saved us. He hit them 2 big threes in the first quarter and got us going. And we kind of picked it up on both ends of the floor.
Now, if you just look at the stats, you wouldn't get it. You know what I'm saying? If you look at the stats, you'll think KCP is an average player. But what KCP brings to the table, you cannot gauge it with the fucking numbers. You cannot. I trust KCP with my life. You can make an argument that KCP has been the best. You can make an argument that KCP has been the third best player in these playoffs. You can have AD, LeBron interchangeable. Then you can have Rondo, and then KCP is right there. Not Kuz. Damn sure not Danny Green. The longest tenured Laker. Kentavious is a Laker for life. I don't care. Sign this man next year. Not for $20 million, like he's getting paid right now. Give him a good $9 million contract. A little 3-year, $22 million contract. Give him a statue out in Staples. Give him a TV deal. Give him some commercials. KCP deserves a commercial. And he has a burner account. He sees the slander. A lot of guys, they see the slander and they shrivel up. Paul George, Danny Green, they see it and they get in their feelings.
Oh, I can't play good.
KCP sees
it. He don't give a fuck.
That's what you need in Laker land, bro. We need hustle. We need grit. LeBron and AD can have the flashing lights and the showtime. The game is won in the trenches. KCP, Morris, Rondo, guys who gonna fight you. Get a busted lip and still get up and play. That's what I like KCP. You have redeemed yourself. And that'll be all for this video, bro. I'm close to 1,000 subs, so make sure you subscribe, my guy. If you're new to this channel, if you like this type of content, I'm gonna drop daily content, so better subscribe. If I don't drop daily content, call me out on it. Like the video, turn on post notifications, and I have a podcast called the Better Thoughts Podcast. It's me and my guy Brett. I will leave the link down in the description. It's on Spotify, it's on Apple Music, it's on everything.